τι έκανα να γράψω.
Όταν πάτε σε κάτι, να το πεις.
This has to last for at least an hour after the situation will be built. So we need from you to stay into the room if you can for the whole hour. Otherwise you can leave, but still you have to give us your feedback before you do. Okay. Today we're gonna invert a little bit the game, which is we're gonna be played from our viewers on Periscope. So we're gonna see what they are gonna tell us to do. And this is our score.
Do you
or she should, you know,
Greek. This is in Greek. Greek.
It is in Greek. Oh, okay. She's a Greek.
For our Periscope users, please note that you can give us any action you want us to do, anything you like.
Thank you.
but I have a very big nose.
The other person is much more well-educated, or describe how you think others perceive you. Okay, let's think things first. When I have this feeling that I'm not in the same wavelength with the other person, and he or she speaks much more fluently, or I don't speak the language so well, I'm losing my own voice.
I think we had a second suggestion, and it was describe how you think other people perceive you. I didn't get the question. Describe how you think other people perceive you.
I think that everybody perceives me as a bitch, which I'm not. I'm just bossy. If I was a guy, I would be bossy, but I'm a girl and I'm a bitch, but I'm not.
Thank you.
squeeze more. Yeah, even more. Do you feel comfortable like that?
A little bit hot.
Come on, smell it, very nice.
I'm losing my balance.
It's like in a subway in Korea, so
nothing changes.
Who's behind me?
Can you speak?
Hmm?
I think that's me.
No. Okay, so this is Greek, it means how are you or what are you doing? It depends. Can do both.
Can I explain to you? We do whatever you ask. So the question was?
Can you give the definition of love?
Something you don't have and the other doesn't want.
The definition of love? Something I have?
Joy.
Maybe to not have a definition for it. something I've never tried to define.
Gravity. I don't know. Every day something different. So, can you tell us something to do? Can you give us an instruction?
Are you leaving?
A critique of the piece so far. No?
Your
not
feedback.
To the camera or to me.
Okay. Feedback was that it was interesting.
Share with us why you are leaving?
Yes, it's not what we were expecting. We were hoping to sit down, see a concert. It's been a long day of walking. We're going to relax.
Don't you want to dance?
No, not right now. But enjoy. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
another order to dance like Beyoncé.
Didn't we all enter the space as free individuals? Why do we need to obey any kind of silly rules someone tells us from the internet?
With lemmings.
What?
Lemmings, sheep.
I thought we were free individuals. I mean, we came to see art. We came to reflect on what is happening in the world. And we end up doing what everyone's telling us on the internet. Let's do something else. Let's try to be productive. Let's, I don't know. Why does this have to end with someone telling someone else to masturbate in front of other people?
Maybe it's the people that left us
that are productive right now.
But is it about individuality or something more collective?
It's about doing something that someone, that no one told you what to do. I don't know, like, we can do all kinds of things in this place. We are like 7 people sitting and dancing like chickens. And we don't even know each other.
Me?
Both.
Esmeralda.
And yours?
Ellen.
And you? What's your name?
Ellen.
Nice to meet you.
And
Daphne. And
so what do you want to do?
That's fine.
I just want to be uncomfortable for a while. People call me uncomfortable. So that's the, maybe the experience of the circle.
Actually,
yeah. How many people are watching this on average, do you know? Like the stream?
Three?
Then I don't feel so uncomfortable.
Let's,
No, no, perfect.
Let's say world elsewhere. Like we already know each other kind of, and there is a possibility to know each other more. What can we do?
Speak, touch, dance.
Anything really.
We have done this already.
Yeah, it's true.
So we can also be silent with each other. It's like the maximum trust. What? Why you don't say anything for a long, long time?
Is it revolutionary to be silent?
Sometimes.
Do you feel that you need a revolutionary action, or...?
I thought the documentary was about that.
You're working for the documentary. What do you think?
Yes. Yeah, actually, yes. I think, especially also the people that work for the documentary, they should use it not as a platform, but they should use the attention that is focused on the event or on the time that it takes place for rogue action, yeah, for doing something that is completely out of the context, that even sticks the finger to, you know, this institution and yeah.
Can we do that here?
In this room?
Mm-hmm.
Probably, yeah.
But it would be easier if you weren't filmed, I think.
Mm-hmm. I could write like hashtag crapomenta on the wall and stream that. It would be a bit superficial, but I mean it's catchy, I guess. But for sure there could be something more radical.
You can use the video. I mean, we could trash the place. Crash. Trash.
Think that the revolution takes place indoor.
But it might start.
We all believe in revolution.
No, I don't believe in revolution. Yeah.
Do you think that the that 9/11, 11th of September 2001, could be called a piece of performance art?
No, I think it's about intention with everything, and to take on a performance. A performance of art is different to a performance or some other intentional action. Action is different to performance.
But if someone would do the same with the intention of calling it art, would you say it's art?
Not necessarily. I think there's conversations that happen beyond an artwork that perhaps create the artwork. I think there are circles upon circles, and I think one direct action doesn't necessarily constitute an artwork.
I think also that 9/11 is not necessarily true. And I mean by that that half people see it in one way and the other half see it in a different, completely way. And all we had from 9/11 was one video. And we have hundreds of different opinions of what happened.
But isn't it the same with art?
But you can draw those parallels, you know, on anything.
But that's what
I know, but I, just because you can do it in one thing doesn't make it.
All that will remain from what we're doing now is video.
No, I don't think that's not true. I will take the experience with me, and it probably resonates with me, so that is something personal I take with me, so it's not just a video.
That's the same someone would experience if they were in the Twin Towers.
This was very difficult.
They would take their experience with them.
In the grave.
Yeah, of course. That's the circle of life. I mean, like, what I consist of are my memories, the moments that I lived, however twisted or however I distort him afterwards, but what constitutes me, I think, is above else, like, yeah, the idea maybe that I have of myself, like consciously and subconsciously, and all the and easy to describe, but
is death the worst thing that can happen to you?
No. No. Death? I don't think I'm... No. I actually like the idea of suicide, you know, and that is something you can find in art as well, like throughout history, even in ancient Greece. It's a sovereign act to take your life, actually, and there's some beauty in that, but no, there's worse things than death, for sure.
I think death is the worst thing which can happen to the people you love, for you, and for the people, when you die, it's the worst thing for the people who love you, not for yourself, because you're dead, and after that, there's nothing.
Well, I think in other cultures there is another interpretation. For example, I was in Thailand in November, and you could see that they consider this, what you just said, as something very selfish.
Something that relates also to, I guess, to the concept of spirituality and personal belief, religion maybe, pseudo-religion, all of that plays into it, and I don't know, I think we're living in these hyper-individual times, like we're all kind of gathering like pieces of ideology together and, you know, create our belief system out of it. I mean, speaking about, I guess, Europe or the Western Hemisphere. And sometimes it might be a bit shallow or a bit nihilistic or something, but yeah, still.
What's the Zeitgeist?
Zeitgeist. No, that's what you said.
Yeah.
Let's go back to our possibilities as a group. I mean, today we entered the space as free individuals, you said, and we try to find something collective, but how, with this strong individuality, could we find a common ground to support this collectivity? To host this collectivity.
Our collective.
Mm-hmm. Our collective capacity as a group, as a bunch of people. I mean, we did something collective because we had this external force.
Yeah. Well, for once I can go out and tell other people about this experience and invite them to come here and to share it as well, and maybe extract something similar out of it than I did. Maybe not, but...
Can we act without the big other?
I didn't understand.
If we can act without with our own agency, like without someone else, without the other. This time was the other internet, someone who was watching. Other times we instrumentalized projects.
Okay, so why do we do art?
What?
If we don't take in what the audience wants from us, why do we do art? It's not psychoanalysis. We can be individuals and still follow some orders. We do it every day.
Yeah, but how we do without? How we do without?
We can't. We grew up in it. So we already follow orders in our head, which exist. How to act, how to speak. I mean, when we speak, we already follow the rules of language, like, so there is no way to not, like, there is a way maybe, but it's a bit more difficult to communicate.
What if we accept all these facts? And just see how we can stay as much as, yeah, as healthy, conscious, and sober as possible.
Why is it important to you to stay sober and healthy?
Someone mentioned before this the word collectivity. I don't think we try to make something collective here. From the beginning, I don't think this was a question. We were just doing what they were saying on the video and adding some, like editing it a bit in order to make it a bit more, to take it to another level in a way. I don't think people felt any pressure doing that. I think the whole process was quite relaxed. So, in a way, my intervention saying that I thought we were free individuals inside the space and that we could do whatever we wanted, instead we're doing what they are saying, was not a breakthrough.
Well, did you feel that we shared this embarrassment doing what we were being told, which I do believe created this kind of collectivity between us? Of course, we didn't take the chance for them to be extreme. We didn't create an extremist situation, but I believe that the message was passed through. We could have done better, we could have done something more violent or something more even weird. I do believe the message got passed through.
I mean, I don't know, I don't really see freedom as, you know, something that means you have to break the order or to go against the grain, but it could also mean like to freely accept what has been told you and to, you know, follow those instructions, but out of your free will, not out of like the necessity or something.
It felt different to say the truth. Strange how it worked somehow. I feel this common embarrassment. I felt like that. And it produced an honest dialogue. And this is and it did make sense today.
This was quite weird, the fact that you left made me think that maybe your feelings were hurt or that you felt bad.
This is why I did it. I want to see your projections. I was sure that you would feel that I was feeling embarrassed. He was successful with the guy. Couldn't stay.
Oh, the hug thing was very, very uncomfortable for both of them.
Was it? Was it sexist? What I did?
What did you do?
Masturbate?
No, I just thought it was funny. Yes. That's why I laughed about it.
Find it a bit boring to, I don't know, always.
And it's not sexy.
Yeah.
No, it's not
sexy.
It's like the
this is the opposite of sexy
thing you can like do anywhere. Yeah, okay, maybe.
Depends, yeah,
yeah, okay, but like here it was like one of the unsexiest things I think you could have done. I think you could have done a lot of things.
I spit it once and someone found it really sexy.
What?
I spit it in the middle of a circle.
Oh, yeah, that would be. It's difficult to say what's more sexy.
It depends,
yeah.
I expected from you to do it, actually.
Today I tried a little bit to challenge not only the audience, neither myself, but also the whole group, because most of the time I have in mind to challenge mostly the members of the audience and sometimes myself, and to really push my limits. But it's been a while that I haven't really touched you, and I didn't know how you felt. But that's why, for example, I said this about the masturbation, or I asked you I said to you that that you look like a performer. So, but that was a bit like a misunderstanding. It's a misunderstanding, yeah. So it was good for me to revisit a little bit this idea. And I think that's why I had a more holistic sense of the group, without so much strong separation between the performers and the audience. And because I have a very performative background, and I rarely feel any kind of embarrassment. But today, actually, with the Beyoncé thing, I was not so comfortable. Sounds very silly, but this is the truth. So it was very important for me to revisit all these places inside me, I think. And that's why I felt a bit more connected in all these possible embarrassment showers, or inside this kind of estrangement, or uncomfortability, insecurity, or the feeling that you don't know what is happening.